This story takes place in the southwestern borderlands of China over 2,000 years ago. When the forces from central China were captured by a local army, they weren't expecting to bring a remote regime into the historical spotlight. Their silent but fierce-looking enemies clutched bronze weapons and dressed strangely, with their hair tied in buns. The soldiers knew nothing of their captors, who they soon discovered were just as curious about them. Why did the Han soldiers suddenly find themselves in the remote border region? The story begins in Chang'an, several years earlier. In 141 BC, Emperor Wu ascended the throne, marking the beginning of the most powerful and prosperous period of the empire. The first zenith of Chinese dynastic rule had arrived. At that time, the empire was economically powerful and the government had large reserves. Historical records describe mountains of coins in the national treasury, so many in fact that the threads connecting them had rotted through lack of use. The granary was too small to house the abundance of grain, and while some was stacked in the open air, the surplus went rotten. Emperor Wu began to realize his ambitions. The empire expanded to an unprecedented degree, and there were major breakthroughs in foreign trade. Before this period, there were only a handful of brave merchants, but when Zhang Qian opened the Silk Road, government-sponsored foreign trade flourished. Goods from the empire reached Central Asia via the Yumen and Yangguan passes. But there was no such route in the southwest. If something like the Silk Road could be opened there, it could expand trade with South Asia. The relatively uncharted mountains and forests of the southwest were inhabited by ethnic groups and considered dangerous. The young emperor tried the region. A report submitted by an official disclosed some important information. According to the people of Bactria in the west, an ancient road existed, linking China southwest with India. The news excited the emperor, who immediately sent some soldiers to investigate. Lacking specific clues, the soldiers were like headless chickens stumbling about in the dark. They couldn't adapt to the environmental conditions, and many got lost. About 6 months after they set out, over half had either perished or been injured. Some found themselves in an area close by today's Dian Lake. They lit a bonfire, and its smoke attracted the attentions of their enemies. When the Han soldiers were released, information about the state of Dien was reported back to Chang'an by an official based at the nearest courier station. The emperor paid great attention to the news and bestowed on the official great honors. He was invited to the imperial court to submit his report and answer the emperor's questions. Hence, the state of Dien attracted the attentions of the Han Empire. This is a true story. The contents of their conversation were recorded by Sama Qian's Records of the Grand Historian. Of the numerous southwestern tribes, the Yelong were the most powerful. There were dozens of other tribes to the west, but the state of Dien was the most powerful of them all. People's hair was tied into buns. They worked land and lived in towns and cities. The state of Dien escaped the attentions of the central government, perhaps due to its remoteness and small size. In 2,000 years, it has barely been mentioned in historical records, except in a few solitary paragraphs. But Sama Qian's records are vague. Did the state of Dien really exist?
We 汉书、后汉书，包括这个《华阳国志》，它关于这段历史的记载，都是抄了司马迁的《史记》西南夷列传，就没有补充更多的新的东西。所以，我们长期以来我们对古滇国的这个了解，就固定在这个司马迁所画这个框框里面。
2,100 years slowly passed. Then, in 1956, some strange-shaped bronze relics appeared in Kunming, Yunnan province. An antique dealer approached some experts with a bronze object, hoping to find out more about it. The experts were astonished.
In 1950s, 筹备处成立，也就是我们这个现在的考古所的一个前身呢，有古董商就送到这个博物馆筹备处来了，就请他们鉴定。第一个看看是什么时代的，第二个就是这个值多少钱，这个是最现实的博物馆。
In China, bronzes appeared between the late Neolithic age and the Han Dynasty. The ones made in the Shang and Zhou dynasties were the most exquisite. They had complicated patterns and many bore inscriptions. But the antique dealer's object was different. It occurred to the experts that it might have been made in Yunnan. But in ancient times, Yunnan was considered a remote land, shrouded in an impenetrable mist. Is it possible that during the Shang and Zhou periods, it had the same bronze culture as the Central Plains? The antique dealer's words prove the expert's speculation to be well-founded. According to the man who sold it, the object was from Liangwang Mountain near Kunming. The astonishing news prompted them to head for the mountain with their archaeological equipment the following morning. If what the dealer said was true, the ancient history of Yunnan might have to be rewritten. They searched every inch of the mountainside, but found nothing. The antique dealer had seemed certain, but the expert's search drew a blank. They wondered whether he was holding back the true source of the object. If so, the mystery surrounding its identity might never be revealed.
那么大田间东西到底哪儿来的？他什么地方出土的？这样碰见这个云南文史馆的这个方素民了，方素梅老先生。这个老先生呢，他家就是晋宁的，他家就是在石家山附近。他就是说他们那个抗战时期那边出过青铜器，好的都被那些地主恶霸的拿去了，然后呢，其他呢，比较残的都当成废铁卖了，被他们废铁卖了。
Everyone became excited. Shazai Mountain is close to Liang Wong Mountain, mentioned by the dealer. They immediately rushed to Shazai Mountain, and as soon as they arrived, they made a great discovery.
They found 这是什么什么东西从哪个坑里面出？同时呢，在村民手里面也收到了与咱们以前在市场的古董商人提供的一样的东西，比方说青铜剑呐、青铜矛啊。
After pinpointing the exact location of the tomb, they carried out an archaeological dig. The bronzes they discovered would astound the archaeological community.
当时，他们用的瓷器是一种安全的瓷器，也是一种象征的瓷器。瓷器的瓷器是一种象征的瓷器，也是一种象征的瓷器。瓷器的瓷器是一种象征的瓷器，也是一种象征的瓷器。
They revealed a sophisticated civilization with highly developed bronze casting techniques. However, unlike the bronzes of the Shang and Zhou dynasties, they bore no inscriptions, which confused the experts.
Regardless of the silver etching itself, or the etching on the silver etching itself, 都跟咱们的北方中原地区的商周青铜器完全不一样，所以当时很多人认为这个东西是云南少数民族的东西，但是是什么时代的不清楚，大家都谁都不清楚，因为谁其中有一位女性在主持这个祭祀仪式，因为从这些遗物。 我理解，它实际上是古滇国时期这些墓主人他们生前所主持过，或者说他们认为非常非常有价值、有意义的一些重大活动。
Do these tombs belong to the mysterious ancient state of Dian? No more clues are found in the subsequent excavation. Most of the archaeological team head back to Kunming, and only a few stay on to finish off. Then a member of the team chances on something that was overlooked.
He calls out to the others, who rush over to find him clutching an object that's about 2 centimeters long. Such a tiny item seems insignificant in a tomb containing numerous large bronze objects. But when they wipe away the dirt, 4 large characters appear. It's the seal of the Dian King. The records of the Grand Historian makes a brief reference to the ancient state of Dian. A seal is mentioned. Emperor Wu of Han once bestowed a seal upon the Dian King and allowed him to continue governing this region. Once again, the mysterious state of Dian appears. This seal is made of solid gold. Moreover, only a king was entitled to have a seal like this. This seal proves that Shezai Mountain was the royal cemetery of the state of Dian. A bronze civilization that had been covered with dust for 2,000 years is rediscovered. Although excavations are finished, many mysteries about the regime are yet to be unraveled.
一个呢是它的起源，就是这个文的它的起源，再有一个呢就是它消失，啊，这样也都不是那么太清楚，一直都不是那么太清楚。还有一个呢就是这个当时这个滇青铜文化所反映的这个我们历史上所说的这个古典国，它的社会形态啊，那么它的这个组织结构形式等等这些问题呢，都是一些。
After the discovery at Shezai Mountain, knowledge of the state of Dian reached a standstill for 10 years. Then, in the rainy season of 1966, an important discovery was made not far from Shezai Mountain, at Lijia Mountain. Lasted for over 20 days. It was the best season for farming, so when it cleared, local villagers began to till the land. The incessant rain had softened the terraces, and after working for a short time, they discovered some strange metal objects.
大叉叉，宝剑，多了小杆子，碰到个斧头，那个一用，我们其中背的，背的这个东东，一用，够了，对吧？另外呢，穿的这个铠甲那个阔阔一用。They
sold the bronze objects to a village shopkeeper. After several days, he had amassed several tons of discarded bronze items. The news soon caught the attention of the archaeologists, who then carried out an archaeological dig at Lijia Mountain.
<音>最大的特点就铜器特别多，哎，不仅说的大型木，一个大型木，那么几百件、上千件，就是很一般的那么小型木里边，也都有几件甚至十几件铜器。
It was a remarkable discovery. According to the data, the number of bronze items excavated on Li Jia Mountain was almost half the amount of those unearthed from the Yin ruins. Their unique shapes revealed that they also belong to the mysterious state of Dian. The burial complex on Li Jia Mountain was a large-scale cemetery for the nobles of the state of Dian. Jinlian Mountain in Yunnan Province lies just across the lake from Li Jia Mountain. In 2006, it caught archaeologists' attention when nearly 200 holes were dug out by grave robbers and fragments of bronze objects discovered. After further investigation, the experts speculated that there might also be a Dian tomb complex somewhere on the Jinlian Mountain. After 40 years, they had finally found new clues. Another reason for this is the location of Jinlian Mountain. At the foot of the mountain lies Fuxian Lake, the deepest freshwater lake in China. Across the lake, on Li Jia Mountain, is the tomb complex. Interestingly, it's the same story on Jinlian Mountain. Elderly villagers still remember finding strange bronze objects on Jinlian Mountain.
五八年，五九年，这个时候呢，这个我们农业秀打仗，盖泰山，盖泰地，就是那个时候我还是杂志店，全部那个，拿牛犁，一犁出来，就是那些小标标、小杆杆，还有毛毛钱，对吧？这些东西，还有种放那放些礼拜那种，我的还放这一块。
These strange rusty bronze objects were also sold to the village shopkeeper.
The
The villagers' accounts fire up the archaeologists. Similar stories can be found around Jinlian and Li Jia Mountains. The two locations are close to each other. What will they find at Jinlian Mountain? May 9th, 2008, after meticulous preparation, the large-scale excavation of the Jinlian Mountain Tomb Complex began. This dig takes place on the 600 square meter area at the top of Jinlian Mountain, where the tombs are concentrated. Many have already been looted. As expected, a large number of bronze objects are removed first. The relics date this tomb to Bronze Age Yunnan, which was also the period of the mysterious state of Dian. Disappointingly, the objects are mainly swords, blades, and everyday items. What's more, they're not as exquisite as those from Lijia and Shazai Mountains. The most famous bronze object excavated from Lijia Mountain is a cow tiger table. Its main body resembles a strong cow. Beneath the cow is a calf. The cow is sacrificing itself to protect the calf. A fierce tiger holds the cow tightly with its claws and grips the cow's tail with its teeth. It's a rare find in China and overshadows everything that was unearthed at Jin. As a result, some experts began to doubt whether the tomb at Jinlian Mountain is actually associated with the state of Dian. Events over the following days seemed to confirm their doubts. Then some human bones are discovered. The date of the Jinlian Mountain tomb complex is shrouded in mystery. According to the researchers' previous experience, no human bones are expected to be unearthed from tombs of the long-gone state of Dian. 2 days later, archaeologists find some human bones in another tomb that has already been looted. No bronze objects are found in either tomb. Further explanation is offered by a tomb excavated several days later. Apart from the human bones, something else is unearthed. It proves to be part of an officer's hat dating from the Qing Dynasty. This further confirms speculation that the Jinlian Mountain tomb complex might have been a public cemetery with a history of over 1,000 years. But a question follows. At the foot of the mountain is a tiny hamlet known as Jucheng Village. How could it have such a time-honored cemetery? Explanations from the villagers grab the archaeologists' attention. According to them, the village was once the seat of a prefecture. But the archaeologists doubt this. In ancient times, a prefecture was equal to one of today's county-level cities. Its administrative level was higher than modern-day Chengjiang County, and its scope of jurisdiction greater. Surprisingly, the local Qing Dynasty records show that the location of Jucheng Village beside Jinlian Mountain was once the prefectural seat. Other chapters explain that a new city was built here during the Ming Dynasty.
Changjiang 就是金陵三角下的旧船村迁到了现在的五凤三角。
In 1571, the seat of the prefecture was relocated to today's Chengjiang. This is the origin of the name Jucheng, meaning old city, which is still used today. The experts are disappointed with the result. If it turns out to be a public cemetery, it will be less valuable. The aim of the archaeological dig is to find out more about the state of Dian. But as they proceed further, other questions arise. More human bones and bronze burial objects are found. It occurs to them that their initial dating of the tomb may be inaccurate. If the tomb dates from the state of Dian, why were such large amounts of human bone found? If it dates from a later period, what do all the bronze pieces mean? Excavations have been going on for a month, but nobody has been able to accurately date the tomb. Jinlian Mountain remains shrouded in mystery. The archaeologists decide to send the bones to the Research Center of Frontier Archaeology at Jilin University. They hope to find more clues. Experts will conduct a DNA test to find out more about the deceased. But they are faced with great difficulties.
当时我觉得可能不乐观，因为我们做过以前做过比较偏南的黄河以南的这个样本，这个成功率都不高。你比如说我们做过这个湖北秭归的，当时也做了十多个样，但是都没有出这个 DNA， 而且它这个还很难辨，而且云南它是红土地，它是酸硬土壤，对 DNA 的破坏是比较严重的。
After 1,000 years of natural decay, most of the DNA in the bones has been lost. It's really difficult to extract what's left. After one test cycle, they're disappointed to find that all DNA has been lost from the bones. They can't even derive the most basic information, like the sex of the deceased. Excavations at Jinlian Mountain continue. Each day, over 10 tombs are exhumed. Despite having no conclusion about whether the tombs date from the period of the state of Dian, the archaeologists continue finding human bones and bronze objects. One day, they find something different. The strange bronze object is about 6 centimeters long and looks more like a plow than a decoration.
像石寨山、笔家山、成贡天子庙，包括这个安宁的这个太极山等等呢，当时的十几个墓地甚至更多都没有发现像澄江金莲山出土的这个。比照原器物形制的1/10，甚至1/20，这种比例制作的器物，以前都没有见。
This bronze plow is a burial object,
which seems related to the culture of the Central Plains. In Han Dynasty tombs of that region, miniature stoves and wells are often unearthed. Is it possible that the tombs on Jin Lian Mountain have something to do with these people? This reminds the experts of something else. When talking with the locals, they hear a legend. Though the archaeological dig has been going on for some time, the villagers don't know much about it. Several elders once mentioned buried treasure on Jin Lian Mountain. They think that the purpose of the dig is to find the treasure. The name Miss Guan refers to Guan Yinping, the daughter of Guan Yu. Guan Yu was a well-known figure in the Three Kingdoms period, 1,700 years ago. Her husband, Li Wei, was said to have been born in Jucheng village at the foot of Jin Lian Mountain. The legend is reflected in some of the local customs. The joint tomb of Li Wei and Miss Guan still exists on Jin Lian Mountain. Since it hasn't been officially exhumed, there was no authenticity. But the Chinese traditionally return to their hometowns in their old age, so the tomb is probably real. According to the oldest existing records of Chengjiang, the tomb is on Jin Lian Mountain. The story of Miss Guan's luminous pearl is just a legend. But the Li family existed and was headed by an army general. The children and their mother stayed home and were guarded by soldiers. If the tomb complex on Jin Lian Mountain has anything to do with the people from the Central Plains, then the story of Miss Guan might provide important clues. Researchers at Jilin University are still searching for clues. Though their last test was unsuccessful, they have many samples. If they can find a small part of a relatively complete DNA sequence and compare it to that of the different ethnic groups in the database, they may be able to figure out something about the remains. The researchers have carried out many tests and have successfully extracted some DNA information. But over 1,000 years of decay has made the DNA information patchy, and it's impossible to find a long enough sequence.
因为我们知道它 DNA 嘛，你长度越长的话，你得到信息越多；你越短的话，得到信息越少。只有信息在长了的话，不同的人才有区别。你比如说就，十个碱基或20个碱基，那咱俩可能那个位置可能都一样，可能到第40个、第50个，咱俩可能就不一样了，有区分了。
After 6 months of testing, they finally obtain a relatively complete sequence from a male tooth. Will they find the information they need?
This is 得到的序列，搜索一下，就是和百越人群的序列比较接近。但是它这个有一些的变异的位点。都是和南方的那个人群是相近的，这些变异位点都是南方人群常见的变异位点。
The Hundred Yua refers to the Yua people who lived in southern China in ancient times. Since they were comprised of many tribes, they were known as the Hundred Yua. The occupants of the Jinlian Mountain tombs might be local men.If so, their descendants probably still live here. But one sequence is not enough to prove it. This is undoubtedly a useful piece of information. The tomb's occupants might belong to a local ethnic group, or may even have been subjects of the state of Dian. The archaeologists are thrilled by the possibility.Another piece of good news follows. A few days later, an unexpected discovery is made in tomb number 287. Some pottery objects are unearthed. Pottery is a more accurate indicator than bronze when it comes to dating tombs.
一般情况而言，就是陶器更能够反映它这个年代之间的差异。就是由于这个陶器和青铜器的这个属性决定的，因为青铜器就能够可以保留到很晚的时候，但是陶器不可能，陶器易碎，所以它的时代性比青铜器。更明显。
Through careful comparison, experts are excited to find that the pottery from Jinli is similar to that unearthed at Shazai in Lijiao Mountains. These unimpressive pottery objects provide compelling evidence. The mystery shrouding Jinlian Mountain is finally unraveled.This mountain tomb does indeed belong to the Bronze Age of Yunnan, which was the time of the state of Dian.
It's a 锤器，他们经常所说的这个锅，就这个，还有包括碗啦、盆啦，就是实际上的生活用具里面包括水器、这个盛器，还有锤器，这些跟这个石代山。为代表的石代山文化的陶器群和青铜器群都是大体一致的，只是具体在形制方面有一些变化。
The experts are excited about this conclusion. 50 years has passed since the first archaeological dig on Shazai Mountain.The veil covering the ancient state of Dian has been pulled back again. The Jinlian Mountain Tomb is undoubtedly another major find from the state of Dian. The tombs at Shazai, Lijia, and Jinlian Mountains form a triangular area which could be the core of the state of Dian.
The excavation of the tomb complex at Jinlian Mountain takes people back to a mysterious regime that existed over 2,000 years ago. Though no exquisite items have been found, these seemingly coarse burial objects are distinctive. These were the tombs of ordinary people of the state of Dian. Can the experts find the answers to questions going back 2,000 years in this tomb complex? A glorious Bronze Age civilization. A mysterious regime in southwest China. A story that has been buried for over 2,000 years. Scattered skeletons and a strange scene of death. What caused its final demise? What was the secret of the State of Dian? Join us for part two of The Lost State of Dian.